a book from 1934, a movie from 1974, and a story that represents the epitome of a dying genre, the whodunit. How can these elements combine to give the remake of Murder on the Orient Express buzzworthy hype? Because the trailer kicks ass. I'm 4K'd from Hero Journalism, and we're going to find out why coming up on The Art of the Trailer. Greetings, Internet. I'm 4K'd from Hero Journalism, and welcome to The Art of the Trailer, where we analyze the craft and execution of the marketing of cinema. Today's subject, Murder on the Orient Express, one of the classic mysteries from the classic author Agatha Christie. I didn't read the novel, but I do remember reading other stories of hers back in school. A lot of the kids did. They were old books, so they often qualified for book reports, snapped up by students scouring the library for the least painful book to read. We didn't know that she was a master of the medium, having written over 60 detective novels and would go on to be one of the writers most frequently adapted in film and television history, with dozens of films and hundreds of hours of TV based on her works. I was introduced to her famous creation, Hercule Poirot, when I caught the film Death on the Nile on TV at Grandma's house. It seemed about as good as I'd find to watch at Nana's, so I checked it out and I became engrossed. It starred the great Peter Ustinov as the detective. Ustinov was one of the legendary Shakespearean stage and film actors of his time, maybe not quite as well known as some of his colleagues like Sir Laurence Olivier and Sir Alec Guinness. He was a brilliant performer, devoted to every nuance of the character and script. Combining his subtle physical idiosyncrasies and voice inflection, he could wring that much more drama or comedy out of even the most simple lines of dialogue. I just loved his comedic execution, so much so that I sought out other Poirot mysteries, but I could never quite connect with the character when other actors played him. So when I heard about the new remake coming out, I wasn't too excited. For me, the draw of Hercule Poirot was Ustinov, who passed away in 2004, and I thought it unlikely a modern actor would impress me. Ustinov is that good. But the new trailer really turned me around, both for its artistry and for its characterization of the one and only detective. If you haven't seen the trailer and want to see it before the analysis, you can find a link in the description and check back here after you're done. Okay, let's get started. The first minute is pretty straightforward, some establishing shots with the title train and some of the characters. The narration comes in, I'm assuming from Poirot, and I realized at that moment I don't even know who's playing the detective. I'm going into this cold. But the narrator drops a philosophical line about the lives of strangers being tangled as they're trapped together during journeys of travel. Already that's a great sign they got the character right, as we see his flair for the poetic. Then there are flashes of more characters. We see Michelle Pfeiffer and Johnny Depp. Hey, I didn't know he was in this. I immediately thought, is he Hercule Poirot? Doesn't seem likely, but who knows? In later shots, we'll see additional cast members like Josh Gad, Penelope Cruz, and Dame Judi Dench. You also see Derek Jacobi, who plays the butler. He's another Shakespearean actor from the Royal Theatre, a colleague of Peter Ustinov's, but a decade or two his junior. So there's a little connection between the film and Agatha Christie adaptations of the past, a bit of movie trivia obscure enough I expect most would miss. Next, the train halts to the stop with a shriek. The murder. So far, the trailer has done a splendid job of setting up the basics. A cast of characters on the train, far from civilization, and stuck there until they reach their next port, and they have to deal with a murder mystery. Then, the trailer kicks into gear with a single, brilliant, long-take tracking shot that ratchets up the tension.
A passenger has died.
Then, as the slow track begins, as Poirot walks down the car, each interaction with the character heightening the tension until he finally tells them, if there was a murder, then there is a murderer with us, and you are all suspects. Wow, just a perfect setup. You know exactly what the story is in just 90 seconds, all culminating in one brilliant shot. And it was at that point I realized I still did not know who Hercule Poirot was going to be played by. And then, as if on cue, we cut to Willem Dafoe.
And who are you?
My name is Hercule Poirot, and I am probably the greatest detective in the world.
Boom! They dropped that like a rock. What a reveal, and with Poirot's trademark high self-regard. I laughed out loud when I saw that. And Branagh as Poirot? Probably about the best casting you could find in Hollywood circles for such a classic character. And that mustache, I've never seen that on a previous Poirot, but it just felt right. The ending music after the climax, well, good, just got a little too modern all of a sudden, but overall I thought it was a great trailer, and the music during that awesome tracking shot was perfect. In fact, the whole thing, just a letter-perfect job at setting up the conceit of the story, and it does it with a dramatic flair that really feels authentic to the source material. Good job, 20th Century Fox Marketing Department. Good job. So that's my take on it. What did you think? Did the trailer get you jazzed, or am I just a pathetic Peter Ustinov Poirot fan hoping to relive some of that past glory? Let me know in the comments below. And if you thought it was interesting, please give it a like, and you can subscribe to get more film analysis from Hero Journalism. This is 4Cade signing off.
Guess we should buy two.